if p equals 3x and x belongs to natural numbers and this x value is less than or equal to 50, means this x we can take till 50. So 3 times 1, 3, 3 times 2, 6, 9, till 3 times 3 is 9, 3 times 4 is 12, like that 3 times 50. So x you can take up to 50. So I'll write some values here like 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30, 33 and so on. So up to 3 into 50. 3 into 50 is 150 will be the last term. Total 50 terms will come. So next here q. 5x and x belongs to here also natural numbers up to 30. Less than or equal to 30. So here you'll get like 5. 5 times 2, 10. 5 times 3, 15. 5 times 4, 20. 25, 30, 35, so on. Up to 5 times 30 is 150. So on, 150. Now see, they are asking P intersection Q, number of elements, cardinal number. But before that, let us see what numbers will get common. So if you'll observe these two, you're getting the multiples of, you'll get the multiples of 15 common. 15, next 30, next 45. You'll get 45 in 3 table and in 5 table. 45, 60, 75, 90, 105, 120, 135 and 150. They're asking number of elements in P intersection Q. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So there are like total 10 elements in N of P intersection Q. So the correct option is 3. In the given figure, DE is parallel to BC and AE is to EC is 4 is to 7. This is 4 and this is 7. Ratio is 4 is to 7. And they are asking BC and DE. See, when they'll ask about, if they'll give AE and EC and if they'll ask about AD and DB, then it is based on BPT, basic proportionality theorem. But when they'll ask about BC and DE, okay, you need to know that, like, we have to prove this small triangle and big triangle similar. Now I'll take the triangles like triangle AED, okay, and triangle ACB. AED and ACB. Now see, angle A is common in both the triangles. Angle A is common. This is common angle. Next, as these two lines are parallel, it is given. So I can take the corresponding angles. Angle 1 equals angle 2. So angle 1 equals angle 2 are like corresponding angles. They are corresponding angles. So triangle AED is similar to triangle ACB by angle-angle corollary. So if you write sides proportional, AE by AC, ED, ED by CB, see. But they gave AE is like ratio 4 and 7. It's a ratio. So AE is like 4 parts and AC is 4 plus 7, total is like 11 parts. ED by CB. Okay, so see, don't in a hurry, don't answer 4 by 11, okay, because they are asking first BC. So they are asking BC by DE. So if you do inverted, no, that is like 11 by 4. So BC is to DE is 11 is to 4. So in a hurry, don't select the options. Carefully see what they are asking. They are asking BC is to DE. So BC is to DE is 11 is to 4. If they ask DE is to BC, then it is to be 4 is to 11. So the correct option is here 1, 11 is to 4. If alpha and beta are the zeros, two zeros of x square minus 5x plus 6. So find the zeros of this polynomial. So 6 factors are 3 times 2. So minus 3x minus 2x plus 6. So x if we'll take common, x minus 3. Minus 2 if we'll take common, x minus 3. So again x minus 3 if we'll take common, x minus 2. So x minus 3 equals 0. X minus 2 equals 0. So x equals 3 and x equals 2. So you can consider alpha as 3 and beta as 2. So they are asking alpha 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square. So 1 by alpha 3, 3 square, beta is 2 square. So 1 by 9 plus 1 by 4. 9, 4 LCM is 36. So here into 4, into 4, into 9, into 9. 9 plus 4, 13 by 36. So the correct option is 1. You can do this problem in alternate method. That is, you need to find 1 by alpha square plus 1 by beta square. If you take LCM, alpha square, beta square. So here you'll get beta square plus alpha square. This a square plus b square you can write as a plus b whole square minus 2ab by alpha square beta square you can write as alpha beta whole square. Now in this method you need to know the values of like what is alpha plus beta, sum of the zeros, like alpha plus beta minus b by a you can do, so minus of minus plus 5 by 1 which is 5. Next alpha into beta is c by a, so no need to do factorization. If you want to do this method directly you can. C value is 6, 6 by 1 is 6. Now these values if you will substitute you will get the answer. Now alpha plus beta, that is 5 square minus 2 into alpha into beta is 6 by alpha beta is 6 whole square. So you'll get 25 minus 2 times 6, 12 by 6 square, 36. 25 minus 12 is 13 by 36. So you can do in this method or in this method. But in this method, you need to know the sum of the zeros formula. And in this method, you should know the factorization, splitting the middle term. If 2 power x plus 3 power y equals 17, so 2 power x plus 3 power y equals 17, and this one is like 2 power x plus 2 minus 3 power y plus 1 equals 5. So here if you write this 2 power x into 2 power 2 3 power minus 3 power y into 3 power 1 equals 5. 2 square is 4. 4 into 2 power x, 3 power 1 is 3. 3 into 3 power y equals 5. Now here see, here this equation is in terms of 2 power x, 3 power y, and this also 2 power x, 3 power y. So what I'll do, I'll consider, let 2 power x consider it as a, 3 power y consider it as b. This equation will become like a plus b equals 17, because 2 power x is a, 3 power y is b, so a plus b is 17. This equation will become 4a minus 3b equals 5. Now these two equations I'll eliminate. So first equation I'll multiply with 3, 1. So 3a plus 3b is 17 times 3 is 51. 4a minus 3b is 5. So on adding these two equations we'll get 3b, 3b will get cancelled. Here it is 56. So a is 56 by 7. So the value of a is 8, because 7 times 1, 7 times 8. So we got the value of a. Now substitute in the first equation, like a plus b equals 17. So 8 plus b is 17. B equals 17 minus 8. So 17 minus 8 is 9. So we got a equals 8, b equals 9. But we consider a as like 2 power x, we consider it as a. So I'll substitute in place of a, 2 power x equals 8. In place of b, I'll consider 3 power y. So 2 power x, 8 I can write as 2 power 3. So on comparing, x equals 3. 3 power y 9 we can write as 3 square, so y equals 2. So they are asking x comma y, so answer is like 3 comma 2. So the correct option is 1. The value of k for which the system of equations, so here see equation like 3k plus 1 into x plus 3y minus 2 equals 0. Another equation is k square plus 1 into x plus k minus 2 into y minus 5 equals 0 has no solution. No solution means the lines are parallel. So condition for the parallel lines is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2. Okay, so here a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. I'll use this to find the value of k. So here if I'll substitute a1 by a2, 3k plus 1 by k square plus 1 equals b1. b1 is 3 by k minus 2. So if I'll cross multiply, 3k plus 1 into k minus 2 equals 3 into k square plus 1. Now here if I'll multiply 3k into k, 3k square, 3k into 2, 6k, plus 1 into k is 1k, 1 into minus 2 is minus 2. So 3k square plus 3. Here 3k square will get cancelled. Minus 5k minus 2 equals 3. Okay, so minus 5k equals 3 plus 2. So minus 5k equals 5. So k equals 5 by minus 5. So k equals minus 1. So the correct option is 3. A box contains 12 balls, out of which x are black. So here total case 1 if you take, total balls are like 12, total number of balls, in that black color balls are like 6. So sorry, black color balls are like x, we have x black balls. Next case 2, total balls, alright, black color, 6 more balls are added. If 6 more black balls are added, already we have x balls, black color. Next, if 6 more are added, then it will become x plus 6. Next, before see here, total balls were 12. Now, total balls will become like 18 because 6 we added. So, now, this probability, okay, the probability of drawing a black ball now, means the new one. So what is the probability here? Like, see, probability is nothing but number of favorable outcomes. Probability of an event formula is number of favorable outcomes by total number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes. So this probability is double of this probability. So for this, what is the probability here? This one is total favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes is black, that is x plus 6, by total is 18. This probability is double the probability of the case 1. Case 1 black balls are x, the time total balls are like 12. Now, here if you cancel, 2 times 1, 2 times 6. So, x plus 6 by 18 is x by 6. Further, if you cancel, like 6 times 1, 6 times 3. So, x plus 6 by 3 equals x, cross multiply, x plus 6 equals 3x, 6 equals 3x minus x, so 6 equals 2x. So if we'll simplify it further, like 2x equals 6, x equals 6 by 2, so x equals 3, so the correct option is 3. 3 unbiased coins are tossed, the probability of getting at most 2 heads. The probability of getting at the most 2 heads. Now see, when 3 coins are tossed, like when 3 coins are tossed, total 8 outcomes. So I'll tell the logic, see how to write the 8 outcomes. Like, write 4 heads, then 4 tails, then write two heads, two tails, two heads, two tails, then write one head, one tail, one head, one tail, head, tail, head, tail. These are the total 8 outcomes. So total, this is like sample space. So this is a sample space. So total how many outcomes? 8 possible outcomes. With 3 coins, you will get 8 possible outcomes. So now they are asking, what is they are asking is, at the most 2. Means see, if you will get 1 head, it's okay. 2 heads, okay. 1 head is also okay. No head is also okay. Okay, so 2 heads is fine. You cannot cross the 2 heads. At the most 2 heads means you cannot cross 2 heads. So you can get 2, you can get 1 head. If you will not get head also, it's fine. But you should not get more than 2 heads. So what are the favorable outcomes? See here, 3 heads. So this case you cannot take this one. Here 2 heads, it's okay. You can take at the most 2, that also you can get 2. Here 2 heads, you can take this. Here 1 head, that is also fine. 2 heads, fine. Here you have 1 head, you can take 1 head. And here you have 1 head, you can take. Here you don't have any head, that also you can take. Because at the most 2 head, they are saying you should not cross 2. But before, less than that is fine. So if you will not get head also fine. So total 7 possible outcomes, I mean like 7 favorable outcomes, total possible outcomes is 8. So probability of at most 2 heads, at most 2 heads when 3 coins are tossed is number of favorable outcomes. The formula is number of favorable outcomes by total number of outcomes. By total number of outcomes. So here favorable outcomes we have like 7. See, total 7 favorable outcomes and total outcomes are 8. So the correct option is 4. In an equilateral triangle, ABC, if AD is perpendicular to BC. See, in an equilateral triangle ABC, ABC, AD is perpendicular to BC. See, if you know the properties, then 3 times the square of a side is equal to 4 times the square of its median. So this is the option. This is the property actually. So, but we'll do it, like we'll prove it. We'll apply Pythagoras theorem. But before that, you need to know the property that in an equilateral triangle, if you'll draw the perpendicular altitude, it will bisect the side. It will bisect the side. Now see here, they all, in all the options we have AB. So take this triangle. Okay. Take the triangle ABD. If they used to give the option AC, then I would have take ACD. Now I took ABD, I'll apply Pythagoras theorem. Like hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. AD square plus BD square. So AB square, because this I wrote with the help of like Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem is, in a right angle triangle, the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides. So here opposite to 90, hypotenuse is AB. Hypotenuse square equals sum of the squares of other two sides. So AD square. So here BD, okay, as it is bisecting, so BD I can write as half of BC. Half of BC. So AB square equals AD square plus BC square by 4. If we'll take LCM, 4. 4 AD square plus BC square equals AB square. So 4 AB square equals 4 AD square plus BC. Also, I can write as AB. Okay, see, because all sides are equal, AB equals BC equals AC, because it is an equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. So you can write as AB. So 4 AB square minus AB square equals 4AD square. So 3 times AB square equals 4 times AD square. AB is a side, AD is a altitude. So in an equilateral triangle, 3 times the square of a side is equal to 4 times the square of its altitude. So the correct option is 2. In a GP, the third term is 24. So third term is 24. Sixth term is 192. Then we need to find 10th term. So nth term of a GP, the formula is AR power n minus 1. So A3 will be AR power 3 minus 1, AR square is 24. And here AR power 5 is 192, 6 minus 1, 5. Now we need to find A10. A10 is AR power 10 minus 1, that is AR power 9 we need to find. Now see, if it is in AP, we used to eliminate the equations. When it is in GP, divide these two equations. If you'll divide AR square and here by 24, A and A will get cancelled, R square, R power 5. So R power 5 by R square is R cube, and here you can cancel with 8 table, or directly it will go in 8 times, or 8 times 3, 8 2 16, 8 4 32, 3 times 1, 3 times 8. So R cube is 8. So R cube you can write as 2 cube, 8 you can write as 2 cube. So R equals 2. So you got the value of R. We need A value and R value. So you got R value, substitute here R value, you'll get the value of A. So A into R is 2. So 2 square equals 24. 2 square is 4 equals 24. 4 times 1, 4 times 6. So A equals 6. The value of A is 6. Now you got A value and R value. Substitute here to get the value of A, 10. A is 6 and R is 2 power 9. So 6 into 2 power 9 is 512. 512 into 2 into 3. So 1024 3072. If you'll multiply this, you'll get 3072. So the correct option is 4. The ratio in which the line segment joining the points 4, 6 and -7, -1 divided by x-axis. See, divided by x-axis, the ratio is -y1:y2. -y1:y2. So here you can consider x1, y1, x2, y2. So minus of y1 is 6:2, y2 is -1. So minus minus cancel. So answer is 6:1. That is the first option. Correct option is 1. So see, if they'll say x axis -y1:y2, if they'll tell y axis, suppose in the exam if they'll ask y axis, -x1:x2. Okay, but here the answer is y axis, they ask is x axis, so the answer is -y1:y2, 6:1. Now this problem I'll explain in detail next. Suppose two points A and B, they gave here 4, 6 and B -7, -1, and divided by the point on x axis. So you'll take point on x axis is x, 0, and you can take the ratio k:1. Directly you'll get the value of k, or you can take m. So p divides in the ratio section formula, mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. So here p is x, 0, because they told x axis. If they'll tell y axis, you'll take 0, y. Now here mx2, x2 is -7, plus nx1, x1 is 4, x1, y1, x2, y2, by m plus n, my2, y2 is -1, ny1, y1 is 6, by m plus n. Now here, if you'll equate the abscissa with abscissa, you'll not get the answer because we don't know what is x. So equate the ordinate, that is y value, y coordinate with y. Ordinate with ordinate. So 0 equals minus m, m into minus 1 minus m, plus 6n by m plus n. Cross multiply 0 into m plus n is 0, minus m plus 6n. So minus m, if we'll transpose, m is equal to 6n. So m by n is 6 by 1. So m is to n is 6 is to 1. Some children, they'll get confused here. M equals 6n, they'll write 1 is to 6. But ratio is m is to n. So m by n you calculate, you'll get 6 by 1. So the correct answer is 6 is to 1.